How's it going, everyone? So today I'm going to be talking about a workout routine for skinny guys to build muscle. So I do want to show you guys some of my pictures first, just so you guys know that I do know what I'm doing. I have built a fuck ton of muscle. I can help you guys. And yeah, you know, you guys, I have been doing this for quite some time. So if you guys are looking to build muscle, I will be giving you guys some honest advice on how to actually get the muscle and what workout routine to do it, because I know you guys want to build muscle. That's the thing. And I know there's just so much misinformation on YouTube these days, and just in general, who can you listen to? So I will tell you guys everything that you need to know, and I will be giving it no bullshit at all. I'll tell you what it takes to build the muscle. So I will be going over to kind of in the background for my longtime subscribers. I know some people don't want to hear about this, so they kind of want to watch the videos, and that's awesome too. So I will be going over that. So I will just go over it real quick. I am doing incline barbell bench. I do my warm-up sets. Then I will be doing 195 pounds for 3 sets of 8 repetitions. Last week I did 3 sets of 10 with 185, so linear periodization. I'm doing 195, 3 sets of 8. After that, I do my weighted pull-ups. I do 15 pounds added on, 3 sets, 8 reps. I think my last set for this one, I only got 6 reps. My last set for my pull-ups as well, I only got 6 reps. So striving to hit all 3 sets of 8. If you don't get it on the last set, that's fine. So what is the best workout routine for skinny guys to gain muscle? The best workout routine is going to be one that you guys love to do. And in my opinion, I can give you guys one that's going to be pretty sweet. So what I like to do is, it's from the old 70s bodybuilding routine, and basically what it is, it's not the same volume or sets, it's not even close to that. It's more based towards natural athletes. So it's going to be, Monday is going to be chest and back, Tuesday is going to be shoulders and arms, Wednesday is going to be legs, Thursday is chest and back, Fridays is shoulders and arms. And Saturday can be legs too if you guys want. If you guys have really skinny legs, then you can train your legs twice a week. For me, my legs are overpowering, so I'm only training my legs once a week. So Monday to Friday for me. What exercises, what sets, rep ranges, what you guys need to know. So if you guys are pretty skinny, you're not seeing results, then you guys need to eat more calories. It's as simple as that. If you guys are gaining a fuck ton of fat, then yes, look into your workout routine. But if you're simply not gaining weight, then it has nothing to do with your workout routine. I could put you on the stupidest workout routine, have you doing barbell curls while you're suspended from a pull-up station, doing jumping jacks with the 200, I don't know, just some stupid fucking shit. I can't even think of it right now, but just any dumb exercise, and you would gain muscle just because we would follow some simple simple progression methods and simple principles. But with that being said, if you guys are gaining weight but you're not seeing as much muscle, then follow my workout routine. But again, if you're skinny, you haven't gained any weight in the last 4 to 5 months, it's 100% with your diet, has nothing to do at all with your workout routine. Because any workout routine, if you're a beginner, any workout routine will work. The biggest thing is building muscle, or gaining weight, making sure you're tracking calories, and making sure you're eating enough calories during the day. So again, I said chest and back on Monday. Here's what I do. Again, you have to switch the exercises up. You can't do the same exercises. If you do them over time, eventually the law of accommodation says your body will adapt to it. So I like to train the exercises for 4 weeks, then I switch them out. So Monday is going to be chest. I do incline barbell bench, what you're seeing here. After that, I will be doing some weighted pull-ups. After that, I do flat dumbbell bench. And then I do bent over barbell row. After that, I do incline dumbbell chest flies. And then I do some barbell shrugs. Now, sets, reps, what do we do? Some people have no idea about this. Now, what I like to do is I like to periodize my workouts. I do linear periodization. Now, for powerlifting, linear periodization won't really work that well. But for bodybuilding, it works awesome. Because bodybuilding is all about total volume, you guys. So the first week, chest and back, I will do 3 sets of 10 reps. Second week, I will do 3 sets of 8 repetitions, usually add 10 pounds or so. Third week, I'll do 2 sets of 7 reps, again, add 10 pounds. Last week, I will do 2 sets of 5 repetitions, and again, add 10, maybe 20 pounds, depending on how we're doing. So
That is how I periodize my workouts. Monday and Thursday are identical. I keep the same sets. If I do three sets of 10 with 185 pounds, Monday and Thursday are going to be identical. Identical exercises, identical weight and sets and reps. Again, it's about total weekly volume. Don't switch your exercises up every week. And again, Monday, Thursday will be identical. Now, shoulders and arms I do on Tuesday. I love this, you guys. Chest and back, why I love doing that is because one, you get an insane pump in your chest and your back, but you also get an insane pump in your shoulders or in your biceps and your triceps. So everything on you is looking jacked. The next day, shoulders and arms. Some people are thinking, well, that that has some overlap. You know, I'm training my triceps on Monday. They're going to be sore on Tuesday. Completely wrong. Your triceps and your biceps take maybe 24 hours, if that, to recover. So they recover extremely quickly. With that being said, Tuesday you'll be 100% fine to give her again. And this day is awesome because you're giving, you're basically giving your own day for your arms. Yes, you're doing shoulders at the start, but the way I do shoulders, I do, what I'll do is I'll do like a barbell, some military pressing of some sort or some dumbbell seated press. I will switch up my exercises, but I'll do that. And then after that, I might do some either a side raise, a seated side raise, an upright barbell row, something for my side delts. After that, straight into my arms. So again, my triceps are still 100% fine. They're not sore at all. So I can give 100% attention to my arms. So many people like to do push-pull legs, and that's what I've done as well, and amazing results. But when you push-pull legs, after you doing your chest and your shoulders, your triceps are fried, so you really can't put that much effort into them. By having your own arm day, then yes, you can put as much effort into it as possible. So for triceps right now, what I am doing is I will do an overhead cable extension for my long head. After that, I will do a lateral head movement, so typically a rope push down. Again, switching the exercises up every 4 weeks. Some different long head exercises: overhead cable extension, seated skull crushers. You can do skull crushers from a 90 degree angle. You can do overhead dumbbell extensions. I just gave you guys four or five different things, so that'll last you 6 months. Then you go back to the same exercise and boom, you gain weight on them. That's how you progressively overload and get stronger. You can't just keep doing the same exercises, the same sets, the same reps, the same routine every single week. It will not work. You have to switch it up. So that's for my triceps. For biceps, I will typically do two exercises. Right now I'm doing the preacher curl, and then I will do, what the fuck am I doing? Seated dumbbell curls. That's amazing, you guys. The pump I get in my arms is fucking insane. So again, I will do the same sets, three sets of 10, first week, second week, three sets of 8, third week, two sets of 7, then two sets of 5. I will do that again. The shoulders on Tuesday and, wait, I do it Tuesday and Friday. They're going to be identical, you guys. The same weight, same set, same exercise, everything. Again, the fourth week after I'm done, then the next week I will switch my exercises up and again constantly rotate them. Wednesday is going to be legs. What I like to do for legs is I find by no matter what squat I do, I never really feel it in my quad. So what I've been starting to do is I do a box squat, pretty well parallel, maybe a little bit higher, and oh my God, I feel it all in my quads. So that's what I do right now. I will rotate though. I might do a high box squat. I might do a front squat box. I might just do front squats, front squat pause. So many different variations, so many different things you can do with that. After that, I will do either a leg press. Right now I'm doing leg press, or I could do a leg extension, a walking barbell lunge, barbell step ups, anything for your quads. Really get the volume in with your quads. So again, I'll do the high box squat. Again, it's not high, it's basically parallel. It might be a little bit higher. Leg press, then I will do something for my hamstrings. Right now I'm doing seated leg curl. You can do glute ham raises, you can do stiff legged deadlifts, Romanian deadlifts, anything for your hamstrings. Then after that, I will do both a seated and a standing calf raise, because different, seated and standing will both work your soleus and your gastro, whatever the fuck it's called. So you have to do both, do an exercise seated and do an exercise standing. I've noticed that my calves are growing extremely fast by doing this. Really make sure you do them both seated and standing. And calves are a muscle that you really need to train to make your physique look big. After that, I will do some ab work as well.
typically one exercise right now. I'm doing standing cable crunches. You can do standing cable crunch. You can do laying ab crunches using dumbbell behind your head. You can do hanging knee raises. You can do leg raises from a pull-up bar. So many different exercises, so many different sets, reps. Make sure you guys are constantly switching it up. So that's what I do: exercises, sets, reps, periodization, and deloading. For a beginner, you may not need the deload if you just started training, but if you're an intermediate, you've been training for about a year, you need to switch your exercises up. You need lean your periodization. So what I recommend for a beginner is I recommend lean your progressive overload. So again, what I recommend is tracking all your calories, progressive overloading, and those are the two major things. Progressively overloading, tracking your calories, getting the proper amount of rest recovery. For intermediate advanced, the same three things apply, but instead of progressive overload, lean your periodization. Fourth thing, changing your exercises up. That's all that's different. That's all you guys have to do. So hopefully I did help you guys. That's how you constantly progress. A lot of beginners, they get to the intermediate stage, they don't know how to progress because all they know is progressive overload. All they know is adding 5 pounds every fucking workout. That does not work after a while. You need lean your periodization, and then you need to switch your exercises up. So that is what you guys do. So yeah, we'll just finish watching this video, you guys. Again, I look fucking jacked when I do these pull-ups. I love these. Really make sure your hands are just hooks and that you're doing it with your lats, you guys. So try not to use your biceps. Of course, you're going to be using your biceps, but really try to focus on using them lats. One more, buddy. Come on. One more. I don't even think I got it. End of video. Hope you guys did enjoy.